Hello, thank you for joining the NCTPI ESL Title III Sponsored Opportunities Broadcast. We're going to see a sponsorships overview for the 2021-2022 school year. We're going to learn about the ESL Title III sponsorships, application and selection processes, commitment, reimbursement, and some questions. The NCTPI ESL Title III sponsorships team consists of three members of the ESL Title III team: Dr. Stacy Daniel, our English Language Arts, ELA, and Languages Section Chief; Theresa Parker, Administrative Specialist; and Sadly Stocks, ESL Title III Consultant for the L Program Quality in the East Region. The NCTPI ESL Title III sponsorship was created in 2018 as part of our vision to build capacity for all stakeholders in North Carolina with regards to English learners. We thought that it is crucial that content area teachers, administrators, and ESL teachers receive experiences and training on how to best serve English learners in their school settings. During the first opportunities in which we have offered the sponsorships, the educators compile some resources because they work on projects with NCTPI education consultants or other educators in the state. When you have access to the slides, you will be able to see the special edition that says "Giving Back to Our Professional Learning Network." This special edition highlights projects developed in different content areas. You will see ELA, social status, and other content areas regarding the support for English learners. Other resource that was collected by the sponsor educators in the past are the collaborative notes. These slide decks contain information from the sessions they were attending. They highlighted some of the resources shared during the sessions and the takeaways. So when you have access, you will be able to see the different Bitly links to the different events that were attended and all the resources that these educators share while they were during the presentations and the event. So what is included in the sponsorship? It is included the main conference registration fee. Per state guidelines, we cover mileage or airfare, lodging, meals, and parking. These expenses are reimbursed to the participant. And we also cover substitute teacher, if applicable, because we know some of our educators might not need this coverage. But this expense is reimbursed to the school district. Once we have selected our educators to attend the different events, we will give you some specific information on how to fill out some forms and submit your reimbursement package. So what is not included in the sponsorship? These three main items are not covered: the pre-conference workshops, the event membership affiliation fees, and car rentals. Some of the events, when you are registering, offer different workshops before or after the main conference. You may participate if you want to, but you will not be reimbursed for those additional fees. So it's important that when you are selected, you receive the information, and you register, you select the main conference and understand that this is what is going to be reimbursed after your participation. The same for event membership affiliation fees. Some of the events, they offer membership and you add something, an additional fee to the registration. If you want to do it, then remember that this money will not be reimbursed because it will only cover the main conference. And the same for car rentals. If you have to go from one location, from your home to the location, and is in state, you need to drive your car, or if you rent a car, we will cover the mileage. We will not cover the fee for the car rental. And what are the steps in the application process? So educators who are interested in participating will attend this live webinar or watch the recording to learn about the sponsorships. They will have the opportunity to review the list of events and explore the websites and see what are those sessions and if the topics covered during the conferences or workshops are the ones they are interested in. Then they will have to share with their immediate supervisor seeking pre-approval. It's important that if you are interested in an event that takes more than one day, you let your supervisor know that you're going to apply for this sponsorship, because if you are selected, then we hope that this supervisor will allow you to attend and will facilitate a process if you need a substitute coverage or all the other items that you need to complete previous to your participation. And then once you have selected the event, from the list of events that we provide during application, you have mentioned to your supervisor that you're looking to be a sponsor to participate in this event, then you will complete your application form. And what are the steps in the selection process? Selected educators will be notified via email by the NCDPI ESL Title III project lead. Once the selection committee has reviewed all the applications and determined who are the educators that will participate in the events receiving a sponsorship, we will notify you via email. Please make sure that when you receive this email, you confirm your participation. You check with your supervisor, you share that you have been selected to participate with a sponsorship, and that you need approval to be able to confirm that you will participate. And then this email notification will have some instructions that you will need to follow. You will not be able to register or book your hotel or make any of the arrangements that you need if you don't follow these directions, because the importance of following those directions in the notification email is that you will have all the expenses that you're going to incur in will be covered and will be reimbursed. If you don't follow these directions, we might not be able to reimburse your participation. So it's important that you don't register, you do not book hotel, you do not complete any other processes like reserve flights before you have received this information, you have confirmed, and you have followed the directions and solved any questions that you may have. We're always on a daily basis reviewing the emails and the Q&A documentation, so we make sure that you have solve all the questions you may have and your participation goes in a smooth way and you have everything that you need. So what is your commitment before the event? Before the event, we want you to make sure, and we have said this several times by now, make sure that you have your supervisor's approval, that they know that you want to participate in this event and you have been selected. Then you should review the website, the events website, to learn about the logistics, how you need to register, if there is any early bird registration fees that you can get, if there are any specifics about the conference hotel. All that information you need to review at the events website, because DPI does not organize these events. So that's what you need to review and make sure that you follow what you need to be able to participate in the event. Then you will need to register and pay for your registration fee and save the email confirmation you receive from the organizers. So you're going to keep that form, that email, and that's what you're going to attach to your reimbursement package. And then you will complete the school district's procedure for substitute coverage if you need it. If you don't need it, then you don't need to worry about this. It's one less step and one form that you will not need to complete with your payroll or finance office. And then during the event, it's important that all educators represent North Carolina, and if they are in out-of-state events or in state events, it's optional for you if you want to share on social media what you're learning in the sessions, session takeaways. And if you opt to do this, if you want to do it, then we ask that you share using our hashtag. So other educators following the hashtag, they have access to the information that you are sharing. And they learn about the sponsorship opportunities as well. Something that is required is that you collect some ideas from the sessions that you attend, because you will be designing a lesson plan or instructional activity after you have participated. And we're going to have a session in which we're going to talk about the lesson plan and how it needs to be. There is a rubric that you're going to receive, and then you will have all the information. So it's not that you have to create something really different from what you are doing. It could be something that you are using with your students, and you're incorporating something that you learn at the event or the sponsor opportunity. So after the event, what we want is that you join the L Teacher Network group in GoOpenNC. When you access the slides, you will have the link to join. And this group, you will have the opportunity to collaborate with other educators who are also being sponsored and that might not be sponsored this time, but want to learn about it. You will also be able to access resources and share your resource when you have participated in the webinar, in which we share the rubric and all the information that you need. And for you to complete the task, we're going to give you 30 business days after the event. So then you will have some time to collect all your information, decide what is it that you want to do, if maybe you want to implement it with your students before submitting it. All that is up to you. And once we have the webinar in which we share the information for you to know how to organize your lesson plan or instructional activity, then you will have that time to work on that and submit the way we will ask you to submit it. And then also, and the most important thing, is submit the reimbursement forms within 10 business days after the event. Once you have finished the event, you're going to receive an email with the reimbursement forms. And these forms need to be completed. If you require, if you needed a substitute teacher, then your payroll or finance office will need to complete that form, because remember, this expense is going to be reimbursed to the school district. And then you're going to add all your other forms and receipts. If you had to use parking, then we need the receipt for the parking. If you, for example, travel out of state and you use a taxi, well, we recommend that you use one of those ride, share rides, because then you can receive a receipt via email. And that's what you're going to send us, because we need those receipts. And then if you have your hotel, then in the morning in your hotel, they're going to send you via email the receipt with a zero balance. And that's the receipt that you're going to submit with your forms. So all those receipts, all that information, once you have been selected to participate in a sponsorship and go to an event, then we're going to give you all that information in a folder organized, so you don't need to worry about losing something. And you will have also access to the Q&A shared document, so you can ask if you have any questions about completing the forms. And I was mentioning the forms. There are three main forms: a cover sheet, NCSW9, and the substitute coverage. So these are three forms that you need to complete with personal information, and you're going to submit this once you have participated in the event. So for now, if you are just applying and you want to submit your application, you don't need to worry about these forms. Once educators have been notified that they have been selected, then we send that information with all the different directions. We show you screenshots of the forms and show you what are the sections that need to be filled out. So you will have all that information. So there is no problem, no worries about that. And all these forms are going to be emailed to sponsor educators. So you will have everything that you need. And then who should you contact if you have any questions? So if you are applying for a sponsorship and maybe something was not covered in this broadcast, or you have something that you're like, I read the application, I went through the slides, and I still have this question, please send an email satli.stocks@dpi.nc.gov, and I'll make sure that I'll answer your question before you apply, so you can do it and you don't have any concerns before applying. And for those educators who are selected and they know they're going to an event and they're getting ready and they have questions about the process, about the forms, all the reimbursement package, then they are going to receive a link with a Q&A shared document, because we try, once we have the sponsor educators, to collect all those questions in this document, because one question that one person might have could be the same that other participants have. So we recommend that if you post your question, we provide the response, the answer to that question, then other participants, when they access the document, maybe it's the same question, then they have the answer immediately and they don't need to wait until we check the document and we submit a response or an answer for the question. If it's something that is very specific, that you feel like, I don't want to put this in this shared document, I need to ask, then just send an email to satli.stocks@dpi.nc.gov. But we hope that all the sponsor educators use this shared document so everyone gets access to the questions and maybe some things that maybe they have not considered. When they see those questions, then those clarified and they understand and complete their processes in an easier way. So this is it. Please just send us an email if you have a question before applying. If not, well, check the list of events. Select the one that you feel will help you the most in your professional learning, professional development, that will benefit your students. And we hope we have the opportunity to work with you and you get selected, and just let us know if you have any additional questions.